afraid I'm married.
Those bandits getting more bold, getting closer to the boys of town.
I let her down.
Mister. She's gone.
Who is?
My wife. She's gone. She went out picking mushrooms in the hills near Hanging Rock, and they got her. The stories are true.
What'd the police do about it?
Oh, about as much as you'd expect. Made me fill out a form.
Beryl ain't strong, but she's a good girl. I'll see what I can do. Seth.
Hey, John. Hey, partner.
Get what you need? Ready to help me?
Not quite. Not quite ready. You see, I wasted a bunch of time looking for that last bit of map. And I got to thinking, Moses was a liar. And I imagined myself doing all kinds of unpleasant things to his corpse. And then I realized...
Realized you were sick in the head? That you needed to move on with your own limited time on Earth?
No, partner. I realized Moses weren't no liar. The issue was Aiden O'Leary, who said he had the body. Aiden died in that flu epidemic, and the bodies weren't even buried yet.
Got the body sitting in the back of that wagon behind you?
Yes, sir.
You're not even going to wait until they're buried before you...
Well, they don't care, do you, boys? Honest folk off to a better place. Apart from that Aiden O'Leary fella, I since Mammy died.
Seth, what are you gonna do with those bodies?
I'm gonna take them back to a nice quiet spot and look for the map. I needs the map, partner. I needs it.
Come on! Loitering with the pile of dead bodies ain't exactly the best idea. All right, I know a secluded spot where we can search these sleeping beauties. Stay left. No need for the people of Armadillo to see my friends back here. Come on, let's get this wagon moving. Where are you? Come on, don't be shy.
What did you say?
I didn't say nothing.
Are you talking to them?
So what if I am? I feel less alone with them than in a crowd of people. The way I see it, they lost their soul, just like me.
You're truly a sick man, Seth.
You remind me of why I hate people. For a man who kills so much, you sure seem to have a problem with the dead. Life kills everyone in the end. They ain't so different from you and me.
Aside from them being dead and rotting, I guess they ain't. All right, Seth. Calm down. You talk to the corpses and I'll drive the wagon.
They're coming after us! Get us out of here! Fast as you can, partner! I'll search these bodies as we go!
Just going on a little trip.
Oh, no need for money where you're going, friend. Devil! Oh!
I'm gonna send you right back.
So, I guess this is goodbye.
Are you hiding something, Seth?
Oh, you naughty little boy!
Woo!
Somebody needs a new cologne. Oh, looky here! I found me a few bullets! Further ain't time for burial, partner. Come on now. Play nice, my lovely. This won't take long. Yeah! This feller had a few bucks on him. Go left here, partner! Thanks, partner. Be seeing you very soon. This'll all be over soon. Make a left! Yes! Here it is! I got the map, mister! I got it! I got it! Looks like the treasure's in Tumbleweed! That's where I was headed! It's fate! Keep going! We're almost there! Hey, you handsome feller. Sit here a while trying to figure this out. I'm gonna be rich.
When you're done with that, get over to Fort Mercer. I need you inside that place.
After I find my treasure, mister.
Mr. Marston, how are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend, Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead. Yes, interesting fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. Wes Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on professional exhumers. But did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy. Your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull, feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business. And this being America, that lubricant with which we concern ourselves is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon, extra hands, and I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? No. The sport of kings. Racing, my friend. The sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating, degenerate like myself can prosper. But come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive.
Now, sir, do yak tooth breach.
Seth is an interesting fellow, is he not?